Hello friends, in this presentation I am going to show about different tax slabs, that is old one and the new one, and different kinds of tax saving investments. This is old tax slab. The various percentages for different categories are given. Up to 2.5 lakhs we don't need to pay any tax. From 2.5 to 5 lakhs it is 5%. From 5 to 10 it is 20%. Then above 10 lakh, it is 30. So for senior citizens and super senior citizens, the concession has been increased. For senior citizen, up to 3 lakh is nil tax. Then for super senior citizens, up to 5 lakh is nil tax. This is new tax slab. They have been revised these percentages recently in our budget. So up to 5 lakh it is nil tax. From 5 to 7.5 it is 10%. From 7.5 to 10 it is 15%. From 10 to 12.5 20. From 12.5 to 15 it is 25. Above 15 lakhs it is 30%. So along with that we have to pay 4% cess. So what is cess? Cess is the tax which is put on the tax amount we pay. I will show you one example. So this example I'm showing for new tax slab. If my taxable income is 20 lakhs. So taxable income is different from your gross total income. Taxable income is the amount we get after deducting all the exemptions. But for this new tax slab, we will not be deducting anything. So your total income is your taxable income. My taxable income, that is my total income for my new tax slab is 20 lakhs. So I am separating like this because I have various percentage to calculate tax. So 0 to 5 lakh, for the first 5 lakh, I don't need to pay any tax. So the tax amount is nil. From 5 to 7.5, I have to pay 10%. So from 5 to 7.5, it is 2.5 lakhs. So 10% of 2.5 lakh is 25,000. From 7.5 to 10 lakh, it is 15. So 15% of 2.5 lakh is 37,500. From 10 to 12.5, the tax percentage is 20. So 20% of 2.5 is 50,000. That is 25,000. Multiplied by 2, it is 50. Then from 12.5 to 15, 25%. So 25% of 2.5 lakh is 62,500. From 15 to 20, that is the last remaining 5 lakhs. The tax percentage is 30. So 30% of 5 lakh is 1,50,000. If we add all these amounts, we will be getting 3,25,000. This is the tax amount. Along with that, I have to pay 4% cess. So 4% of 3,25,000 is 13,000. So I have to add these two things. Then I will be getting 3,38,000. That is my tax liability. New income tax regime, who should not choose? So now when we are going to file the tax, we will be using old tax slab 1. This new tax slab we have announced in the recent budget, which we are going to use in our next financial year. We have the freedom to choose old one and new one. Which one we are compatible and in which tax slab you will be paying less tax, that tax slab you can choose. If suppose if you have already invested in any of investment schemes, then you better choose the old one, because in the new tax slab all these exemptions are not allowed. But the tax calculation is very easy. If suppose if your total income is less than 5 lakh, you better choose the new income tax regime, because up to 5 lakh it is nil tax. So what are the main exemptions we have to forego in case if we select new tax slab? LTA. LTA is nothing but leave travel allowance. This is given by your employer twice in 4 years. That means 2 travels are allowed in 4 years. This LTA we have to forego if we select new tax slab. Next one, house rental allowance. So they have given 3 components. The exemption for HRA is minimum of these 3. I will show you the example. HRA calculation. I'm staying in Chennai. Chennai is metro city. So for metro cities, it is different percentage. I will tell you. So my rent is 12K. My basic salary is 30K. My HRA given by my employer is 15K. So how do we calculate HRA benefit? The first component is actual HRA received. That means this is 15K. This is given by my employer. So I have to multiply with number of months. So 12 times 15K is 1,80,000. This is my first component. The second component is 50% of basic salary if living in metro cities, or 40% for non-metro cities. I'm living in Chennai and it is a metro city, so it is 50%. So what is 50% of basic salary? It is 50% of 30K, that is 15,000. So 15,000 multiplied by 12 is 1,80,000. This is my second component. Third one, excess of rent paid annually over 10% of annual salary. That means rent paid minus 10% of annual salary. So what is the rent paid? 12,000 multiplied by 12 is 1,44,000 minus 10% of annual salary. So what is 10% of 30? That is 3,000. Annual salary. So 3,000 should be multiplied with 12. So 3,000 multiplied by 12 is 36,000. If we subtract, we will get 1,08,000. So consider these 3 components: 1,80,000, 1,80,000, and 1,08,000. Which is the minimum amount? 1,08,000. This is our HRA. So likewise, we are calculating HRA. This exemption also we have to forego if we select new tax slab. Then standard deduction of 50K, reduction in respect of interest on deposit. If you are depositing in any savings account, so we will be getting interest. That interest also not exempted if you choose new one. Deduction for entertainment allowance and employment or professional tax. Then housing loan interest. If you have taken housing loan, you will be paying interest. So that amount is exempted in our old tax slab. This is not in the case of new one. Then deduction of rupees 15 lakh. If any of your family member is getting pension. Then the most commonly claimed deductions under section 80C. ALSS, NPS, PPF, tuition fee, LIC, PF contributions, these are not allowed in new tax slab. The deduction claimed for medical insurance, disability tax benefits, and tax break on interest paid on education loan. So now the interest is exempted for old tax slab. This we have to forego if we choose new one. So how do we choose our tax plan in our next financial year? So what should you do? You just calculate your tax liability and in which one you are paying less tax, that tax slab you can choose. Next one, we are going to see tax saving investment sections under 80C series. So the maximum amount deductible cannot exceed 1.5 lakh. So these are the sections under 80C. If suppose I have invested 1 lakh for LIC and 1 lakh for ELSS, then totally I have invested 2 lakhs. 2 lakhs in LIC and 1 lakh in ELSS. So totally I have invested 3 lakhs, but I'll be exempted for only 1.5 lakh. So together under 80C, we will be getting exemption of 1.5 lakh. Then schemes of 80CC, see, when you're contributing to pension funds, so that will come under this series. And when you are contributing to pension scheme of central government, that you can show under 80CCB. Next one, ELSS funds. ELSS funds is abbreviated as Equity Linked Savings Scheme. This is the best way to save tax. It has the lock-in of 3 years. It is delivering historically higher return than FD, PPF or NPS because they are investing in share markets. So the financial planning must be done in the start of the year and not in the end of the year. Why? Because whenever you see the Nifty fall, at that time you can invest in ELSS because you will be getting more units for the lesser amount. If you are doing the same in the end of the year, you will not be much benefited. There are 3 types of ELSS funds. First one is turbocharge. It is very risky but very rewarding. Second one, moderately aggressive. It is moderate risky and stable growth. It is less risky. So whatever fund you can choose, you will be benefited like that. Next one, investment in tax saving FDs under 80C. Tax saving FDs are like regular fixed deposits. It has the lock-in of 5 years. The FD interest rate is varying from 5.5% to 7.75%. The minimum investment limit is 100 rupees. So whatever the interest you earned is taxable. Next one, PPF, EPF and NPS. PPF is public provident fund. So the resident Indians are eligible to take PPF. EPF is employee provident fund, where you and your employer both will be contributing for PF. When your salary is less than 15K per month. Then next one is NPS, National Pension Scheme. You will be getting high rate of interest as the lock-in is high in this. Next one, investments in ULIP, Unit Linked Insurance Policy. It is the combination of both insurance and also the investment. So part of the money is invested for providing insurance for you and the rest of the amount is invested in stock markets. Up to 1.5 lakh is eligible. You can buy ULIP for self or spouse or your child. So the interest rate is varying from 12 to 14. It does not have any maximum limit. How much ever you want, you can invest. Investment, withdrawal, and maturity amount, all are tax-free here. My personal advice is, you better avoid this scheme. If you want to take both insurance and investment, you take the insurance separately and invest in ELSS or SIP. Because this ULIP is not providing these two things fully. Next one, Sukanya Samriddhi Yojana scheme. This is under ATC. This is aimed at betterment of girl child. So when you have a girl child, you think to invest in this scheme. Till she attains 10 years of age, you can open the account in the name of your girl child. 50% of the deposit amount can be withdrawn when the child reaches the age of 18. The interest rate is 8.5 and the investment amount is limited to maximum rupees 1.5 lakh. Investment, withdrawals and maturity amount all are tax-free here. Next one, tax-saving investment sections under ATD, ATDDD. So ATD, we are getting exemption for medical insurance under this scheme. I'll show you an example. If the individual and the parents both are below 60 years, you will be exempted for 50K totally. For you 25 and for your parents 25. So totally 50K. If the individual and their family member are below 60, then 25K exemption. And if the parents are above 60, then 50K exemption. So totally 75K. If self, family or children, any of the members are above 60, then 50K is exempted. Then for their parents, 50K exemption. So totally 1 lakh is exempted. So this has been revised in 2018 budget from 30K to 50K. Next one, ATDDD. It is the deduction of rehabilitation of handicapped dependent relative. So whatever the expense you are incurring on medical treatment of disabled dependent, that amount you can show under ATDDD. And also, if you are depositing any amount under the specified scheme for the maintenance of the handicapped dependent, so that also can be done under this section. If the disability is from 40 to 80, the fixed deduction is 75K. If it is more and severe, then the deduction is 1,25,000. Next one, ATDDB. Deduction of medical expense on self or dependent relative. So previous sections, the ATD is for medical insurance and ATDDB is for medical expense. If the individual or Hindu undivided families below age of 60, a deduction of up to rupees 40K is available. For senior citizens and super senior citizens, up to 1 lakh is eligible under this scheme. With ATE, deduction in respect of interest on loan taken for higher education. Listen here, you are exempted only for the interest paid and not for the repayment of loan. ATU, if the taxpayer is suffering from a disability, then he has to furnish a certificate of disability. Then up to 75K is allowed as deduction. And for serious or severe disability, 1.25 L is allowed. And the disability has been defined as one of the following, that is blindness, low vision, leprosy cured, hearing impairment, locomotor disability, mental retardation, or mental illness. We have come to the final part. The art is not making money alone, but in keeping it. You're very true. How much amount you have saved is very important than how much amount you have earned. We have known about all these schemes. So plan your tax slab in our next upcoming year, which one is suitable, that plan you choose. If you have any queries on this, please drop mail to HarmonicsTraders@gmail.com. Check our below educational YouTube channel. And this is our website. We are providing free and paid services for equity and commodity calls. This is our free Telegram channel. We are providing free calls here. So please do join and get benefited. Thank you. Have an awesome day.